rated PG for parental guidance suggested.
And this is Thought Crimes.
The Dahomey women, a fierce group of elite fighters that defended the kingdom of Benin. These women were so formidable that nearby leaders never wanted to come into contact with these ladies on negative terms. The myths of Amazonian women has always been alluring in European lore, but only in the continent of Africa have these women ever been documented. The Dahomey women had the task of guarding the royal palace, royalty, and fighting for the territory of Benin. The Dora Milaje from the Black Panther comic book series were inspired by the Dahomey women of West Africa. They too are an elite fighting militia that duties correlates with the Dahomey women, protect the kingdom, palace, royalty, and Wakanda's territory. First introduced in 1998 by writer Christopher Priest in Black Panther Volume 3, Issue 1, The Client. We saw the introduction of the Dora Milaje and how they had a strong resemblance to the Dahomey women of Benin, also known as Minho. According to the Black Past, the Amazons of Dahomey were a military corps of women appointed to serve in battles under the direction of the Fon King, who ruled over a nation that included much of present-day southern Togo and southern Benin. They emerged during the 18th century and were finally suppressed during the 1890s. The Amazons were chosen from among the nominal wives of the king called Ahasi. Similar to the Black Panther T'Challa, choosing women from different tribes within Wakanda to be a part of the Dora Milaje, his own elite squad of warriors that happened to be women. The Fon's elite army, known as the Dahomey Warriors, were recorded to be around some hundreds to thousands of women. An exact number has never been calculated with certainty. In the Black Panther trailer, we see an elite squad of women protecting T'Challa, but we do not know the extent of the numbers pertaining to the Dora Milaje. Despite some criticism from Black people online, the Black Panther in Wakanda has constantly been updated, mostly by Black authors like Christopher Priest, who introduced the Dora Milaje in 1998 to the Black Panther comics. It helped make Black Panther more authentic by using African aesthetics and culture. Many do not know that for centuries, the African continent was a leader in innovation and wealth, a continent that birthed astronomy, physics, mathematics, medicine, microbiology, food processing, metallurgy, textile manufacturing, engineering, building technology, and more. It comes to no surprise that the first bastion of equality with the roles of women were within the African continent. In many African societies, women played a vital and important role. They were not limited to birthing children. There was a balance in yin and yang, although outside influences would eventually break down centuries of forward thought that propelled human society. The Black Panther and Wakanda would face similar challenges as a fictional character, but that is a story for another time. Let us showcase more facts about the Dahomey women by Prince Solomon.
A noted fact about the Dahomey women were that they had three main wings, the right, the left wing, and the elite center wing, or Fanti. Each wing had five subgroups: the artillery women, the elephant huntress, the musket bearing frontline group, the razor women, and the archers. They served in conjunction with male troops. According to blackpast.org, their training was grueling and extensive. Once sworn under oath as a Dahomey warrior, they could never marry or have children. The Dahomey women were sworn to celibacy under death. Outside of military duties, they had their royal house duties to attend to. These occupations were indigo dyeing, weaving, selling mats, palm oil production, distribution, sewing, and embroidering cloths. Basically, they were women that could kick your ass and sew a nice garment. The Mino, meaning our mothers, also known as the Dahomey Amazonians, were known for beheading their foes on the battlefield, wearing light West African armor with textile cloths above and various weaponry. They were a fierce sight to see. The Dor Milaje were also well equipped in training, fighting techniques, intelligence, and beauty as their origin source. Young black girls should know that they came from a powerful ancestry of beauty and intelligence. Young black boys should know that they came from a powerful ancestry of men that sparked the renaissance of thought and creativity. There is nothing to be ashamed of. And in Chapter 3 of Black Panther Unmasked, we will discuss the tribal wear and kingdoms that influence the Black Panther.